I'll juice you up.
Some of you might remember, long ago there was a time when people were allowed to go out and do simple things like drink cocktails with friends. Strangers were often kind to one another and usually didn't engage in violent fistfights over a few rolls of toilet paper. The year was 2019, and I was on a plane from Sydney flying back home to Perth. There was just under 2 hours left before we landed. The in-flight movie selection was limited, so I decided to put on the one movie that had a runtime that would allow me to finish it before we landed. It was a fairly recent release, but it was one that I hadn't seen or heard anything about, like at all. I figured what the hell, and I put it on. After all, if it wasn't interesting, I could just close my eyes and catch some Z's before we arrived in Perth. But as it turns out, I didn't close my eyes. In fact, I couldn't take them away from the screen. That was how I discovered 2018's Blindspotting. And man, oh man, I am so fucking glad I did. Written by and starring Raphael Cassel and David Diggs, Blindspotting is a fresh, simple, and stripped-down story of two best friends from Oakland, California, who are forced to face not only the current changes happening in their own lives, but the change of their neighborhood and what it ultimately means for them and their place in it. What else can I say? The film is fucking superb. It's craftily written, wonderfully directed, and beautifully shot. Also, the cinematography in this movie is just spellbinding. From the opening scene to the last, it's just candy for the eyes. The story is tight, focused, and engaging, and although it touches on some serious social issues, it never feels forced or preachy, and it never beats you over the head with any of its messages. Also, there's not a lick of CGI bullshit anywhere in it. And man, that's so refreshing. That's right, no CG, and it doesn't need it. It relies solely on its story, its cast, its characters, and not a single second is wasted. Raphael Cassel is fucking brilliant as the short-fused but lovable Miles, and Diggs is perfect in the role of Colin, the film's other main character. The story follows Colin through his last week of probation. He's just trying to keep his head down and get through it, but when he witnesses a police shooting, he begins to reassess his place in the world as a minority, his friendship with Miles, the choices he's made, and the ones he still needs to. The dialogue is smart and sharp, and the story manages to mix elements of drama and comedy in a way that's creative and fresh, and does so without losing its tone, its message, or your attention. The filmmakers went all out on this one. It's clear Cassel and Diggs put a lot of passion into this, and it shows. It's a nothing held back indie tour de force with moments that are everything from poignant and thought provoking to confronting and tense to just outright hilarious. Blindspotting didn't get the attention it deserved upon its release, but with a new series on Stan based on its characters with the same name, maybe now it will. Better late than never, I suppose. If you haven't seen it, do yourself a solid and check it out. I can guarantee you won't be disappointed. And if you are, well, maybe you're just a moron. It's available online at Amazon and on iTunes to rent or buy. I'll leave a couple of links below in the description to take you straight to those places. I'll see you guys next time with episode 3.
I gotta go shower and do some stuff anyway.